Thank you. Enjoy.
How did this become so popular?
On Instagram.
Just somebody ate it and was like, it's great?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I heard, by the way, you gave this guy the business last time he was here.
Aw, no, I was trying to. It's just complicated because I'm not open yet.
I know. I've heard. Enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Chrissy's Pizza. It is the New York pizza sensation right now on social media. Like, I've seen this place so many times on my timeline. We've tried to come here. They sell out instantly. They can't make a ton of pizzas per day. It's all over TikTok. The girl who gave me the pizza, Austin, you've come before trying to be like, hey, Dave, want? Nope. She gave you the business. We came another day and saw, I wish we had, I don't know if they want to be on camera, the two guys running it. They look so down on their, we walked in and it looked like someone just ran over their cat and dog. They're like, we don't have enough. We don't know how we're going to make enough pizzas. We had to shut down for the day. They were gracious enough to re-DM me like, hey, we're going to do pizzas now this Tuesday. I flew in just for this. You got to pre-order it. You got to get a time slot, 4 p.m. That's what I got. And here it is. And like I said, no joke. It right now, bar none, is the hardest pizza to get in Manhattan. It's not even really close. I've been trying to do this for what, a month and a half? Month and a half, 2 months? One bite, everyone knows the rules. Chrissy's, and if you saw it, you wouldn't even know it's here. Like you just, I've had three people, I'm waiting, be like, where are you doing next? It's like Chrissy's, they look at it, it's like, is it even in business? Yeah, it's in business.
Well, I mean, I didn't even know this was a pizza place. Like, anything cool in the area? Okay.
They don't seem, and let me say this, they clearly don't need any publicity and probably don't want publicity because they can't even handle the crush they have. It does look great. One bite under, everybody knows the rules. He started off making it in his apartment during COVID, I think. Isn't that what you said? Looks right up my alley. The 4 o'clock time slot, Chrissy's, a viral Manhattan pizza sensation. Cute dog. I really like it. Now, is it worth plodding 2 months of travel around trying to get it? No, I wouldn't say that, but it's very good. Super crispy, the way I like it. It is light too. 8-2? It's a legitimate 8 pizza. So 8-2, I think that's a fair score. Definitely though, the scarcity of it or the difficulty of getting the pizza is putting this in like almost a mythical category. Like, oh my God, have you had Chrissy's? It's an 8-2. It's great, great pizza. But the fact you can't get it is making it seem like it's a 9-8. I'm glad I have it. I'm a pizza man. I can't be living in a city and not try the pizza that everyone's like, have you had it? Have you had it? Have you had it? And like I said, it's all over social media. So 8-2, let's see. They strike me as the type of guys who don't want to be on camera and tell their story, but maybe we can ask them if they want to be on camera and tell their stories.
Hello.
Can we get your story or do you not want to be on camera?
I'd rather not be on camera.
That's kind of what I thought the answer was going to be, but I figured I'd ask anyways. Yeah, it was really good. Yeah, really good. All right. 8-2. Yeah, which is like anything over an 8, spectacular. So how many are you guys making a day?
60
pies a day.
Yeah.
And are they still selling out? How far in advance?
So like when I put it up, you know, it sold out in 15 minutes.
It's crazy. All right, appreciate it.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay. Have a good day.
Thank you. There's the mysterious. I knew he wouldn't want to be on camera, so I got a couple answers. How many pies are you making? 60 a day. They put them on sale 2 weeks in advance. They sold out in 15 minutes. 2 weeks in advance, the pizza is selling 15 minutes, period. They're like the hottest. It's Taylor Swift and Chrissy's Pizzas right now. Those are the two hardest things to get in the world. And I love everything. He's not doing it intentionally to be mysterious, but the mystery and intrigue of what they're doing is making this thing like gold.
Okay.
like this.
Yeah.
Shout out Kush Factory right here.
Yes, sir. Kush Factory, New York.
What's the address?
422 East 9th Street.
Oh, so I got to roll this shit myself.
Nah, I got you pre-rolls, too.
I love it. That's thinking. Yeah. Thank you, man. Thank you. Appreciate pizza. Get high.
You got pizza? Is that one good?
Great. Taste it.
I'll try it. Yeah,
it's good.
It's really good.
What's going on?
Wow.
Yeah.
There's knife.
Yeah. Yeah. You want a slice?
I just watch it every time. Shit, I'm not gonna say no. Well, sorry about that.
Thanks, man.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, there you go. What do you think?
I think it's pretty fucking good.
Yeah, it is really good.
My favorite spot is that East Village.
East Village?
Right on that corner right there.
I think I've done that. This is better than that.
Yeah. Low key. Don't tell him I said that. So. I love y'all over there.
See ya. Yeah. Cool. Thank you for the weed, man.
Cool, man.
Take care.
Thank you.
Love New York. Friendly city.
Awesome,
you,
appreciate
yeah.
you, dude.
Let me know what you think.
Let's see. Did let's you see. Like East Village
pizza? What's that?
Did you like East Village?
Got a good crust.
That's what it's
got
great.
A good crust.
I can't remember. Someone just else just said
that's
East
really
Village.
Good. Like, that's the place where everybody goes.
This is real good.
Yeah, you did during the marathon.
It was good.
Oh, I ran through
it. East Village pizza and kebab. One bite. Everybody knows the rules.
Wow.
Pretty fucking good crust. This is another 8.
Yeah. I'm sorry, he's not going to do it. But can I get a picture of you guys too?
Of course. Yeah.
I'm a girl, so I'm gonna get pictures of everything. I don't care. I don't have my phone on me right now.
You got his coat?
Yeah, of course.
All right.
Trust, of course.
Yeah,
let's good healthy relationship.
With that with coat. I can't play those games.
Play silly games, win silly prizes, dude. Yeah. Try to tell
happy
you.
Happy wife, happy life.
There you go.
Take
forward
care.
Question, but you guys don't smoke, right?
No, although, why? Do you?
Yeah, yes, I do. I was gonna bring you one to the shop.
They just brought us some.
Baron.
Yeah, they just literally came down and gave me some pre-rolls. I mean, I'll smoke these. I don't smoke all the time. Is this what you were talking about?
Yeah, I mean, no, that's not what I was
it's
talking about. I'm
talking
about over here, Baron. I wanted you to meet my guy, Baron, over here. They just started this factory over here. Hell yeah, if you need me.
They just brought it literally 5 seconds before you came. They're like,
he wants to know your one puff only. Just have a great day.
Thank you.
See you guys so much, man.
Yep.
Take care, bro.
Yeah.
Yo, what's up?
This is big fan. Yo, my name's Baron. I got an on cannabis collective right next door. You know, you got
boys, this must be like the weed part of it.
No, we're not a weed store. We're very community over here, you heard?
What do you mean not a weed store? You are a weed store.
No, we're an art and cannabis collective.
Oh, art.
Yes.
It's weed art.
No, art and cannabis. You come for the art, you stay for the bud. Come take a look. You want to come sit? Come on.
Where is it?
Right next door.
I'm trying to talk to him about this.
Don't leave your stuff out there.
Where
are you going, dude? This is New York City, dude. Don't do it.
Well, aren't we just going right here?
I'll carry it, dude.
No, I'm not going to have you carry it.
We're going right here. You see this? Look. You see that shit right there?
What shit?
Once I did that, I knew this place would be mine. Well,
I don't know what that means.
One of our next artists is going to be Eric Monroe from The Source. But in the meantime, we give the community a shot. We give the artists a shot. This guy's from the LES, NYC.
Who?
Where are you?
This guy?
You got a hat?
He thinks he's a tough guy, too.
I
want to
show you back. So back here, we have Canna Live by Dr. Green. We've got all kinds of edibles. Pre-rolls, flowers,
this is what I like.
But really, what's the best part is the back door, too.
So come back here. These are some of the members. You know, you guys
have
any stuff, duck out,
like
chill.
Yeah, hey.
Can I get a picture with you?
Yeah, sure.
See ya. Everybody, you know, I swear to God.
How you doing, man?
This is like the most New York thing ever.
Thank you, man.
Cool.
No, awesome. Scotty Bags.
What is it?
Scotty Bags.
Scotty Bags?
Yeah. How you doing?
I like that name.
New York City artist.
Okay.
Look me up. I do body painting and stuff like that.
Okay.
We do some events here. We do events all over the place, but I do good stuff.
Scotty Bags.
Yeah.
Look him up. Scotty Bags. What do you do?
Artist. I'm a New York City artist. We do all kinds of different things. I do graffiti. I do cannabis. I do special events. I do parties. I do all kinds of underground parties.
Bags.
Actually, I got the nickname Bags from selling handbags. Gucci, Louis Vuitton, Coach, the actual.
I love that.
You know, that's how I actually got my name.
So. What his middle name is, though.
But that's my graffiti name also, so if you see that written in the street somewhere, you know that's me.
Scotty Bags.
Scotty Bags with an S, because there's an actual official New York City Bags with a Z out there, and he's awesome, too.
So you guys are just like, this is like a little club or something?
Yeah, you know, it's a membership. You come join us. It's no fee. It's phone number, email. You have access to the space. We have multiple other locations all over Manhattan. You know, and I appreciate you guys for stopping by.
Yeah, how long have you had it for?
So, we've had it for a year.
Okay, cool.
Fight Club. I'm about the Happy Monkey for 5 years.
You guys know Happy Monkey?
The official Dr. Green here, is that's the Happy Monkey brand.
No, I'm not like a
so listen here, let me tell you what this is here. So, Hannah lived here, that's the second part of the building here. He's officially our, you know, retailer or whatever, like. But the Happy Monkey, Dr. Green, we had a penthouse on 38th Street for 5 years when it was illegal. We got people off the street, gave them a safe place to buy and smoke their weed. And for 5 years, so then when we went legal, you know, that place was expensive to keep because it literally was a penthouse off the street, sixth floor, elevator only, private. You had to be a member. So we gave, now we have three spots. We have this spot, we have one in the Bronx and one in Harlem. We do the same thing. We give people a safe space to be off the street, out of view, quiet, nice, respectful. And we're trying to do our thing.
Do you still sell bags? No, is that in the past?
That's in the past, yeah.
All
right. But every once in a while I do get orders. So come Valentine's Day and Christmas and everything, I do get some orders. People still hit me up from back and, you know, hey, can I get that back?
Cool. I love it. People are going to love this story.
Like, I appreciate you for coming in.
Yeah.
I got the torch now. You guys need a safe spot to chill. You want to get money, network.
I get the munchies every time I
see
you.
What are we doing?
There it is. I know. I know. It's a pretty good marriage.
No, I appreciate you guys very much.
Yeah, no, I'm glad. This is great. This is like New York 101. People love it.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Cool.
Take care. See you guys.
I know.
Is that a screen mask?
I found this on the street, though. I have an idea, though. I want to become a, I'm a writer. I'm an artist, who paints and stuff, musician. And two months ago, I stopped selling drugs, though. I've been selling drugs around here for 25 years.
You just stopped?
I want to make money, man. You know, like, I want to, you know, help. I want to go to Africa. I want to go to Russia. I want to go to Ukraine.
World traveler?
Yeah, man. You know, because I want to help people.
Yeah.
I want to be a school, hospital. People, they don't have, like, for the poor people. But if, when I die, you know what I'm saying? Like, and then my kids, I have my kids. They don't deserve me, like, left now. My testament is going to be for the poor people.
I like that.
Well, I live in alone, though, because I'm 42 years old. And I can't really live with mommy.
Yeah.
Or life, you know what I mean?
I hear.
It's time for me to move on. Become a man, you know. Maybe people look at me like if I'm a little kid.
All right. Good luck,
you
man.
Know, like, that's the worst. They will be mama, though. But she's going to punish you all the time, though.
Yeah.
Your mother, it's your mother.
Yeah, it's your mother. You get punished.
Yeah,
that's why I moved out to.
You have to accept the punish. God, he's not going to punish you. He never punish anybody. He forgave. So I'm going to become the film director, Rafael Fondue. And let's see what happens. I'm saying, I hope, like New York, I'm an American citizen, you know, in the United States. And let's make, let's use technology to be a better future.
No, it's a great message.
And when everybody comes together, Jews, Christians, Muslims, Chinese, we can stop the world.
World peace.
Only real men can stop the world. He said, that's it, enough, no more war. It's like you Russian, American. Yeah, I mean, no, we're friends over here. Nobody's gonna fight.
I like that.
Only little kids fight, you know what I mean? Like school.
I like the message. Take it easy,
man.
This is New York. All right, Austin. I thought that was beautiful. It was moving.